While we were winding down at the LA Auto Show last week, Buick was revving up at the Guangzhou Auto Show in China. That's where it debuted a pair of new concepts, the GLA flagship and the Smart Pod. Let's dig right in. We'll start with the Smart Pod, which frankly looks a little stupid, but as a design study meant to push the envelope of what's acceptable in automotive design, looking a little stupid is kind of par for the course sometimes, and it's perfectly okay here. Now, the compact minivan is fully electric, built on Buick's Ultium platform, and fully autonomous, as evidenced by the fact that there is not a steering wheel to be found anywhere in the cabin. However, the design here is the star of the show, both outside and in. You gain access to the inn via sliding side doors, like most vans, which give you access to premium seating for two passengers, or up to four passengers if you fold the bench seat out of the dashboard. Never thought I'd say those words in that particular order. Four seats if you fold the bench seat out of the dashboard. All right. Now, in the two-seater configuration, passengers can kick back and relax, maybe have a cup of coffee, get some work done on a fold-out table, or enjoy media on the 50-inch screen that slides up and out of the dashboard. That screen can also retract back into the dashboard, leaving just the top edge exposed, kind of like those rollable OLED TVs that we saw from LG at CES a couple of years ago. Now, the two premium seats are also what Buick calls sleeper seats, which means they can fold flat so you can lay down and catch a nap while you're rolling through traffic. And because you don't want people peeping in on you while you're sleeping, most of the glass is semi-opaque, which means that it lets lots of light in and gives you a clear view of the area around the car so that you reduce that sort of feeling of claustrophobia. But from the outside, you get this slick, windowless looking design that people can't see through. Now, while you're sleeping, you can take advantage of noise canceling technology for a quiet cabin and ambient sound to sort of lux the place up a bit. Sounds great, but they'll probably never build this thing. Though, I'd love to see some of these pug-nosed, futuristic little van design elements from the exterior make their way onto a more realistic van sometime in the near future. Now, speaking of more realistic, the GL8 flagship looks like what would happen if Buick told Lexus to build them a minivan based on the Sienna. Go figure. It's a concept that's designed to preview a potential future replacement for the GL8 and GL8 Avenir minivans that are currently on sale in China. Now, up front and at the rear, you've got these sort of contrasting silvery areas. And up front, you've got these L-shaped LED light signature that's supposed to be an evolution of Buick's wing-shaped LED design, that sort of upside down Nike swoosh that you see in the headlights of the Smart Pod we just looked at earlier. But to me, the sort of pinched headlights and big old grille just scream Toyota Mirai up front. Meanwhile, out back, you've got a rear end that looks like a simplified version of Toyota Sienna, the way it sort of concaves in with those vertical tail lights. Now inside, they've concepted the cabin all the way up. You've got stuff like a mostly glass roof, these sort of floating chairs that slide and rotate to and fro. There's even a tea set that matches the design of the interior that's integrated into its own little table. Now Buick says that the design motif of the interior is the mountains and rivers and waterfalls of Chinese art. And overall, the inside and out look really good. I especially like the profile, where they're doing some very interesting things with using subtle curves in the sheet metal to imply character lines. And if I'm not mistaken, what looks like a creased glass back behind the sliding rear door. I don't think I've ever seen that before. Probably won't make production, but overall, again, good looking van, but I'm a little bit disappointed that it doesn't look like a Buick. That's kind of a bummer for me. Anyway, comment down below. Do you think that the GL8's design is too Lexus? Not Lexus enough? Would you rather just be taking a nap in that Smart Pod? I wanna know. Anyway, that's what's happening in the news today, but it's not all of the news. Curious about Lincoln's concept for the Chinese Auto Show, or what about the latest drama between Ford and Rivian? You'll find all that and more over on theroadshow.com.